Hello everybody, welcome to this YouTube clip. In this YouTube clip, I will learn you how you can protect yourself with demonic influences. I'm a medium from the Netherlands, I'm Robert van den Broek, and I have lots of experience with spirits and with angels, but also demons. And I will tell you first that God is stronger than the demonic world. And I will tell you about the cases from Annelies Michel. She was get lots of possessions from demonic creatures. And priests was try to help her. We all, humans and animals, and also extraterrestrials, are forming a collective consciousness in a positive way. And that can we call God. And that forms an identity that you can call God. But we have also a collective consciousness that is forming an identity that you can call Satan. And you have some demons, they try to let people believe in anxiety, let people believe in pessimistic things. They try to send you anxiety feelings and through the backside from your head and your neck. A couple of weeks ago, I was in my bed, I was trying to sleep, and I sleep every time in the dark with no light on. And I'm not many times scared. But then I was feeling that some person was coming closer and closer. And it was giving me some anxiety. And then I was trying to sleep and I was falling asleep. And then I was hearing a sort of group of birds, you know, like going to my back from my head. And I was wake up and I was feeling and I was knowing instantly that I was getting an attack from demon, you know, and then I was turning the light on and it was go away. I will say that light workers and mediums will get attacks from demons. When you have a job to do for the light, demons will stop that. But don't believe in what demons tell you. They are liars, and it's not true. God is not believing in anxiety. God is stronger and bigger than anxiety. The cases from Annelies Michel is very heavy. She was unhappy. Very sweet lady, young lady from Germany, and she was get out of the blue blackouts, and then her parents would go with her to the hospital, and so they was making a brain scan, and they was discover nothing, and then the doctors were saying maybe she had epileptic attacks, but she was starting to see demons, monsters. She was hearing voices that would say the most horrible things. She was starting to eat dead birds, you know, with the feathers and everything. She was starting to eat insects. She was starting to eat, poop. It was terrible. And then she was get sometimes a very heavy voice and was talking very loud. It was not her voice, but the demons was coming through her. And then two priests was coming and was trying to do exorcism of her. They was trying to get the demons out. Sometimes things was throwing through the room when nobody was doing it. Sometimes people was hearing boom, 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 tap, tap, tap. Also her sisters was hearing this. When she was seeing statues from Mary, from the Holy Mary or from Jesus, she was starting to be very aggressive. And she was get almost 62 exorcisms from the priests. And on July 1, 1976, 1976, she was dying. And it was very painful. She was dying in a possession attack. Very terrible. This shows how mean demons can be, you know. It was terrible. And I will show you, there are some voice clips, original voice clips from Annelies Michel when she was possessed. And you can hearing the voice from the demons, and it's horrible. I will say to you, it's really horrible. You can feel the evil. You can hear it in the exorcist sessions from the two priests, and I will show you how her voice was. You know, it's the real voice from the demon that was talking through her. Terrible. And most sad part of the story is that she was dying. And that's very sad, you know. The information that I get from her now is that she is now in the light and that her soul is saved by the Lord and by God. I will tell you something about the biblical history from Satan, what the Bible is telling from it. I'm not, will sound like a religion person, but in the Bible, there are some truths, you know, some things that was sent to prophets and prophetess and give messages. And I believe very strong also in Jesus. The Bible learn us that you must have an angel. There was an angel in the past, and his name was Morgenstar. And he was having a very high function in heaven. But he was starting to be jealous to God, to his big function. And he was talking bad to some angels, you know, about God. And then God was thrown out heaven and was sent Satan to the earth. And also the angels that was standing on the side from Morgenstar, from Satan. And we call it Lucifers now. And Satan was in the Bible in the beginning very good, good, enlightened, sweet angel with a very high function. But he was not agree with it. He was jealous on the function from God. And then God was sent him back to the earth. Satan was starting to think, you know, Morgenstar was thinking, you know, I will start to destroy the plan from God. And he was starting to, they say that then the wars and the evil things were starting on this planet. That's the biblical version, but I believe absolutely that demons exist, but God is stronger and the angels are stronger and they will winning for all the time. But there are some creatures between some dimensions. They try to let you believe in negativity. They try to make you aggressive. You know, they try to let you believe that there is no life after the dead. You know, that we are chemical products. You know, that there is a lot of negativity. And there is a big fight going on this planet now between the light and the darkness. Lots of people suffering now. And lots of people have mentally illnesses or panic attacks. And the reason is that the world is starting to be very cruel. And that's the negativity that tries to stop the light, to block the light. But don't believe in this negativity. The light will win in every time. Many times when somebody will tell something to some loved one or to a friend or to a family member and think, this is the right moment, you know, that I will tell him this, what I feel. And then when it not belongs to the ears from other people, that you will tell something intimate. When some people decide, I will now tell this, then the telephone is going and that person that is standing for you, your loved one or your friend, and you want to tell him something, then his telephone is going and he say, oh, sorry, I must answer this phone now and we talk later about it. Or somebody is going in, open the door, or is walking in your room and is, you know, visits the person spontane, and then you have not the chance to tell what you want. That's many times negative influence that coming then on that moment. Not all the time, but many times. I will also say, people, watch out with drugs, watch out with alcohol, when it creates holes in your aura and it make your vibration, your radiation from your aura, it makes it low and you suck then lower creatures to you. I will give you now a healing, and that's very important. This is not my, you know, talk about demons is not my favorite part, but everything what you give intention will grow bigger. And that gives me the positive mood to give the positivity, more intention. I will give you now a healing to clean your aura. And I got also the message that when I give this interactive healing, that you can come also free from possession, can come also free from demons or lower spirits, and don't be afraid what is happening to you. This YouTube clip healing is working every time. It's a sort of code that will work every time, also over 4 years or 10 years. I will show you also this. This is exactly what's going on, the fight between God and the devil, the goodness and the bad things. Jesus is one of the biggest masters from this earth. Jesus was make heaven more humanic. In the beginning, God is so big that you cannot make it understandable for people. God cannot make himself understandable for people. He was too big, and he was sent some part from himself in the form from a human, so little as a human, and that was Jesus. And he have make heaven more humanic, that we can come in heaven and can feel God in a safe way, and God can experience us in a safe way. And now, the less times, the last years, there is coming a sort of disconnection with God, you know, and that's a problem. We must reconnect with the source and not believe in the negativity, but believe in the positivity. Jesus is one of the biggest masters that can help us to come free from negative energy and from demons. So when you want help, you can ask Jesus all the time for help. I will give you now the healing. Don't be afraid when some things are happening in your living room or in your sleep room now, where you are now. Maybe you see me now on this moment on the smartphone. Maybe you are in the hospital or in a clinic, or maybe you are at home. I will send you now this energy. It's possible that you see that you are shocked one moment, that you maybe see that there is coming a sort of monster apparition for my face. When you see this, it is not mean that I'm a monster, but that mean that through my mediumship, through my canal, the demonic influence that is around you on that moment will clean up, that God helps you to come free from negative demons. Maybe you're hearing a loud bam in your home. That means that the negativity is also go away, of when that something, it's also possible that something is dropped on the ground or that the lights are flickering. Don't be afraid. That means that you get help now on this moment. And I will send you now energy from heaven, from the light, the world where we go to when we are passed over, and where your loved ones are now on this moment also. It is also possible that you see some dead relatives. That means that they will say hello to you, that everything is okay. It's also possible that your body will shaking for a couple of times, you know. That means that the positive energy is starting to fight with the negative energy in your body and in your spirit, and that the angel sucked the negative energy away. And I will send you now the healing. Thank you very much for watching. When you have got some supernatural experience, you can write it as a comment under this YouTube clip or on my Facebook. When you will keep it for yourself, that's also no problem. But when you want to tell it other people, or you will write it in the form of a comment under my YouTube clip, the helpers from the other worlds like that. The reason is that you spread the message from positivity, love, and God consciousness then, and learn people that God is bigger than the negativity. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in another YouTube clip. Bye. God bless you.